the India.
This call is now being recorded.
In fact, I am very happy because Dr. Deshmukh sir has been associated with us for last so many years. As you are all aware, he is an ex-professor and head department of microbiology, Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar Marathwada University, sub-center at Osmanabad. And he has got varied experience of teaching and research for almost 4 decades. And after his retirement, he is actively participating. Actually, in fact, he's the founder and president of Microbiology Society of India. And I think he has done a yeoman service as far as getting all the microbiologists all over in India together. And in fact, he's doing a lot of activities, although this is a pandemic time, and maybe we are not in a position to meet today in the physical form, and this has to be done in a virtual manner. But I think in last several years, so many activities has been taking place under the aegis of the Microbiology Society of India. I'm also thankful and welcome resource person, Dr. Sanjeev Patankar, who is going to give. Who is going to give a lecture, a presentation on bio-innovations and bio-entrepreneurship. He is also associated with the Microbiology Society of India as the president of Maharashtra and Goa unit of Microbiology Society. He's a senior faculty who worked in the Department of Microbiology and later on retired as a principal of Shiv Prasad Sadanand Jaiswal College, Gondia, in Maharashtra. He was also the winner of the Young Scientist Award, and he has various innovation and collaboration to his credit. Today, I think India is looking at the innovation as the central government has launched many, many schemes which come under the startups, innovation councils, innovation centers. In fact, we have just started our innovation center just a couple of days back. And we are actually inviting all our young faculty and the student to be not only the entrepreneur, to be an innovator so that this country of 130 crore population with more than 65% young people will take this country to become a superpower. I think today we will be knowing what are the different bio-innovations and bio-entrepreneurship, how one can take this, not only being a microbiologist, but being a science person. And I think Dr. Patankar will be in a position to put before us what are the different innovations which are possible. And some of these ideas, if they are shared and taken forward by our young faculties and the students, I think in Goa, we will achieve something for which this national webinar has been organized. And as I said, we have just now under MHRD and AICT, we have just registered our IIC. That will also help us in giving more training, more facilities to our students at PES College. I welcome all of you and congratulate Dr. Flori, Dr. Caroline, and entire team of Microtech Cell and Department of Microbiology, postgraduate as well as undergraduate departments, and feel that this type of the webinars on innovative ideas we will continue to have so that we really put before our young mind people, young minds that are coming to our undergraduate and postgraduate program to see the stalwarts like Dr. Deshmukh and Dr. Patankar. And I feel that some of our young people, if they idolize these two people and go into their footsteps, I think that will not be a mean achievement as far as we are concerned. Once again, I welcome you and very thankful for listening to me. Somehow, because of the technical problems, I could not get in before 2 PM, and therefore I just apologize for this to my two guests, and I hope this webinar will definitely excite the new thinking and new ideas in our young faculty and in our young students. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for your lovely and warm welcome. And I would kindly request Dr. Flori Pereira, the convener of the webinar today, to give us a brief about today's webinar. Flori, ma'am.
Good evening to you all, and thank you for joining us for today's webinar. I, Dr. Flori Pereira, the convener of today's webinar, on behalf of PES's Ravi S. Naik College of Arts and Science, I'm privileged to welcome the respected chief guest of today's function, Dr. A.M. Deshmukh, President of Microbiology Society India, our esteemed resource person, Dr. Sanjeev Patankar, President AMI Maharashtra and Goa Unit, our respected principal, Dr. Vikas Pisurlikar, Vice Principal Sri G.P.P. Kanolkar, HOD of Microbiology, Dr. Caroline Fernandez, my fellow colleagues and faculty and students from all over India. I trust that you are healthy and safe from COVID. In the past few months, we have seen how the coronavirus has affected our lives in numerous ways, be it socio-economic, cultural, or environmental. Two of the sectors that have been most affected are the educational and industrial sector. Online is the new buzzword. Scores of people have lost their jobs or have been displaced and forced to fend for themselves. They say necessity is the mother of invention. Hardships have propelled humanity to be innovative and think up ways and means for survival and betterment of human life. All of a sudden, biology has taken center stage, and bio-innovations and bio-entrepreneurship have stolen the spotlight. Startups is the new technical jargon, as you know. Even the Prime Minister of India has given a clarion call to make in India. Today, in spite of lockdowns and social distancing, we no longer need to wait for somebody to employ us. With a little guidance, we too can be the next Ambanis, Tatas, or Narayan Murthys, or even set up another biocon. For those of you who want to know how to get on the bandwagon, we present to you the most brilliant minds from the field of microbiology. We have amongst us two of the stalwarts, Dr. Deshmukh, the founder member of Microbiology Society, and Dr. Sanjeev Patankar, who is also an academician, innovator, and industrialist. Both are a package. I'm sure that they will definitely be able to guide us, and we will gain immensely from their extensive knowledge, years of experience, and fantastic networking skills. Once again, our sincere gratitude and a warm welcome to both of you, sirs. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Flori Pereira, for your lovely words and for explaining to us and giving us a heads up about what we can expect from the webinar today. I would like to kindly invite our HOD for undergraduate Department of Microbiology, Dr. Carolina Fernandez, to now introduce the chief guest, Dr. A.M. Deshmukh.
Welcome, everyone. Respected Principal, Professor V.G. Pisurlikar, the resource person, Dr. Sanjeev Patankar, teaching faculty, students, and participants, the chief guest of today's webinar, Dr. A.M. Deshmukh, President of Microbiologist Society India, former professor and head, Department of Microbiology, Dr. Dada Saheb Ambedkar Marathwada University, sub-center Osmanabad, has 37 years of teaching experience. So has 82 paper publications, 32 of which are published in international journals. So has guided 17 research students for their PhDs, and one student is still working. Sir has completed one major and two minor research projects. Sir has written 4 books and edited 7. Sir has organized 45 state, national, international level conferences, seminars, workshops in India and abroad. Sir has worked as a chairman of Board of Studies in Microbiology. Besides, he is a member of RRC, BUTR, environmental committees of many universities and the government. Sir was a resource person in 234 conferences, delivered talk in 49 colleges and universities abroad. Besides, Sir has given talks on radio to create awareness on topics such as biofertilizer, biopesticides, pure water, vermicompost, environmental pollution. Sir has published 20 scientific articles on biotechnology in Marathi language. Sir has presented papers abroad in a number of countries, to name a few: Japan, Malaysia, Nepal, Bangladesh, Thailand, Indonesia, Dubai, Singapore, Mauritius, Bhutan, Sri Lanka. Sir has organized international conferences in over 12 countries, has conducted virtual classes in microbiology for the benefit of a large number of students. Sir's research areas include nanotechnology, biotechnological solution to e-waste, biodiversity of actinomycetes, biogas, and dye degradation. Let's welcome an eminent academician, scientist, and stalwart, Dr. A.M. Deshmukh. Over to Larissa.
Thank you, Dr. Carol Fernandez, for that very well-spoken introduction to our chief guest for today. Now I would welcome Dr. A.M. Deshmukh, President of Microbiologists Society India, to please say a few words. Sir?
Thank you. Thank you for nice welcome and introduction. And I really appreciate the efforts of RSM College of Arts and Science, Harmagudi, Ponda, and its microbiology department for arranging a webinar on an excellent topic, today's need, bioinnovation and bio-entrepreneurship. As already Honorable Principal Dr. Vikas sir has rightly pointed out the need of the topic, and it is the need of the country, need of the nation, because every country in the world is going for development and development. But the problem is whether that development is a sustainable development. Answer obviously is not. Then the question arises, who can do sustainable development? It is expected. And the answer is biotechnologist and microbiologist can do the sustainable development. How? By bio-innovations and bio-entrepreneurship. This year, our goal, our theme of the Microbiology Society is a bio-entrepreneurship. And our Honorable Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi ji, also made an appeal for startup
India. So it is our duty, it is a duty of everyone from the microbiology subject to serve the nation via biotechnology. And I'm really happy with the team of microbiology department at your college, including the Flori ma'am, who is regularly in touch with me, Sunita Borkar ma'am, now present head of department, and Larissa ma'am, and other members of your team are really contributing in the development of microbiology in Goa. Now, I am also thankful to Honorable Dr. Vikas sir for creating good academic environment in your college and for promoting such activity. As a president of Microbiology Society, I want to give assurance to the Honorable Principal and their trustees of your college that with this good team, we will create a miracle in Goa. We want to serve the Goa. We want to serve the nation. And these are the ways, these are the means. So as Flori ma'am has told me, more than 200 members have registered for today's webinar. It's a great success. Slowly, slowly, we'll reach to all microbiologists. And I'm also sure that Dr. Sanjeev sir will definitely inspire these students. He will clarify the idea of bioinnovation. It is not a research. Bioinnovation is always a simple, simple things. A simple idea in mind can create a bioinnovation, and thus the bioinnovation is a need of the future in India. So I am very happy today for giving me permission, giving me an opportunity to interact with the student. Again, as a president of Microbiology Society, it is my duty to wish all you the best wishes, and I'm sure after this webinar also, you will continue with many, many academic activities. Thank you, madam. Thank you again.
Thank you, Dr. A.M. Deshmukh, for your words of wisdom and for inspiring us with your brief speech right now. I would kindly request Mr. Anchit Parkar now to introduce Dr. Patankar. Mr. Anchit is a lecturer in our UG division of Department of Microbiology at our college.
Thank you, Larissa. Dr. Sanjeev Patankar has a PhD in microbiology from Nagpur University. He worked as senior faculty at Guru Nanak College of Science, Ballarpur District, Chandrapur, in the Department of Microbiology. He also served as principal of Shiv Prasad Sadanand Jaiswal College, Morgaon District, Gondia, from 2014 to 2019. He has successfully completed several minor and major research projects funded by DST and UGC. He has 20 research papers to his credit, published in national and international journals. He has written two books published from Lambert Academic Publication, Germany. He's an expert on Vidarbha Development Board, a statutory body of Government of Maharashtra for health and hygiene of tribals. He is also a member of Board of Studies at various universities. Sir is the president of Microbiologist Society India, Maharashtra State. Sir's area of interest includes microbial physiology, microbial metabolism, fermentation technology, enzymology, food safety, food microbiology, and biostatistics. We are honored to have you, sir, as a resource person.
Thank you, Anchit, for that introduction to our very dear resource person, and a very warm welcome to Dr. Sanjeev Patankar. Sir, you may now deliver the talk. I want to inform everyone that this national webinar is also being streamed live on Facebook. So you may take over.
Hello. Am I audible? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So good afternoon to all of you. Thank you, Larissa madam, and Anchit sir, for my lucid introduction. I am very much thankful to RSN College for inviting me as a speaker on bioinnovation and bioentrepreneurship. I am thankful to your principal sir, Vikas Visurulekar, and Flori madam specially, because she has shown the interest to conduct this particular program. Now, as Dr. Deshmukh sir rightly said, that our theme of MSI this year, it is on bioentrepreneurship. So we expect that many more colleges should go for such type of the activities, and I myself expect this because as I am president of Maharashtra and Goa unit for MSI. So once again, thankful to you, all of you, for giving me this opportunity. And without wasting much more time, we will go for today's topic. So is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Now is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So today's topic is bioinnovation and bioentrepreneurship. Now, as I had already told you, and Deshmukh sir also told, that bioentrepreneurship is our this year's theme, and this particular theme we had chosen because in the post-COVID situation, the career opportunities that we had to look for in a different manner. At the same time, our Prime Minister of India, Modi ji, he has also given much more stress on the startup and all other things, innovations, bio-innovation. Government is also asking the universities to go for innovation and start incubation centers and innovation centers. So when we generally talk about the career opportunities in microbiology or as a whole in life science, there are so many type of opportunities we give, right from education, R&D, then industry, in the industry, quality control, production, and so many other things. Nearly about 10 opportunities are there, including the IPR and so many other things. And in that, we say in the last, the entrepreneurship, it is what it is, one more opportunity. But when we say entrepreneurship, now that is what, that is a very big opportunity and it's a very vast field. For other things, we guide the students, particularly for going in the education, in the research, how you can prepare for research, that is for appearing for the CSIR and NET, then how you can prepare to go in the industry. We provide different type of the training programs. We offer different type of practical through our curriculum and so many other things. But what is about entrepreneurship as such and the bio-innovation? Now here, we have chosen this particular topic, bio-innovation and bio-entrepreneurship, because these are the two things, these are the things which are the which are the two sides of what, two sides of the same coin. Because without innovation, we cannot think about entrepreneurship, and entrepreneurship always requires the innovation. So we have to see what is the innovation, what is the invention, what is R&D, what is entrepreneurship. So let us see what is the innovation first, that is the innovation in general. Now innovation, it is commonly defined as coming out of what? The new combinations, which include the introduction of new goods. Now we may prepare a certain type of product, a new product, or a method of production, the opening of new markets even. If the market is new, that become also the innovation, because of our development of certain type of the process. If we are getting the new market, so that is also innovation. If we get the new supply of raw material, we use the new raw material for the production of same product, that is also innovation. So that is what the, because of that, the organization and the industry that grow. Now innovation, it is sometime it is related to what? To the invention. But it is not always the invention and innovation are the same. What is innovation and what is invention? Invention, it is what? It is something which we find out new, which we invent. Because of what? Because of the R&D. We go for a certain type of the principle. We give a certain type of the innovative type of invention as such. It is what? Certain type of the rule or like that we develop. So that is what? That is the invention. But innovation, it is what? It is nothing but it is a practical implementation of invention. So whenever we develop a certain type of the, or we go for an invention, if we prepare a certain type of the rule or certain type of the thing, we invent a new thing. But exactly what is its practical implementation? It is what? It is nothing but the innovation. So because of which we have to make a meaningful impact in a market or in the society. For example, we give what? We invent a certain type of the enzyme. An enzyme is invented. We report that the organism is producing this and this type of the enzyme. But unless and until we give its practical implementation, what is happening, what is it is doing in a commercial way or in a social way, we cannot say that it is an innovation. So the application of that invention, it is what? It is nothing but the innovation. And always you keep in mind, innovation doesn't require every time the new invention. It may be an old invention which is not, which is newly or which is in a different way it is applied forward to a certain type of the certain type of the problem. Now I can give you a very simple type of the example. Now this is the frugal type of innovation. Now you can see this picture. What is this picture? This is the plant. On the outer side of the plant or at the tip, one person is touching the stethoscope. Now a question will come in your mind: what is the role of stethoscope with the plant? What it is doing, what person is doing with stethoscope with the plant? Because all of you know the stethoscope, it is used for diagnosis of for checking the heartbeats of what of the human being or the animal. So now what is this picture it is giving? Now actually this is the detection of what? Detection of the root borer disease. Root borer disease by use of stethoscope. Now you can see root borer disease. What is the root borer disease? The root borer, it is what? It is it is present inside the soil and it bores the root, takes what? That particular pest, it takes the entire type of the nourishment. But when it is boring the root, it gives a sound. That sound we cannot hear. Now the one particular type of the farmer, because of his experience, he was a school dropout farmer from Orissa. He thought that if the bore, it gives the boring inside what? Boring pest, if it is giving the bore inside root, it gives a sound. We can detect this sound on the outer side if we use what? If we use the stethoscope. Simply as we see the heartbeats of what? Of the human being and animals. Now he used this particular thing and then he could hear the boring sound of what? Of that particular pest inside the soil. And you can detect that the plant is suffering from the root boring. Now this is the very important thing. The farmer can do any type of the curative measure. Now stethoscope, it is what? It is only of 400 rupees and it is the old invention, basically used for the animal and the human being. But now he has applied it for what? He has applied it for the plants. Now this is the innovation. Now that particular farmer, he was not a scientific person. He was a school dropout only of 8th class and he gave this particular innovation and many of the farmers, they get benefited. Now this is the innovation. Here there is no invention which is given by that farmer, but only simply he applied that particular invention to what? In a meaningful way to the agricultural way, into the agricultural field also. So this is the thing which is going on. So this is called as what? This is called as called as the innovation, and such innovation doesn't require a new type of the invention. So here now this innovation, it is what? It is a multi-stage process. Now that particular farmer, when he applied this thing to what? To the agricultural field, naturally it is not the at once type of the reaction, but he must have gone through a different type of the things, multi-stage process. It must have gone in his mind. He must realized that it is a borer pest making the sound. If it is a very feeble sound, how I can detect? He simply applied that if the doctor can detect with the help of stethoscope the heartbeats from outside, why I cannot? Now this is a multi-stage process which was going in the mind of the of that particular farmer, and because of that ultimately he gave. Now we can have a similar way. Now this is the very crude type of the innovation, one can prepare a biosensor which could detect this sound vibration by using what? By using the piezoelectronics or some certain thing, and we can have a biosensor based on what? On the sound made by the pest. So that is again also in a similar way. But for that purpose, we must know the knowledge of piezoelectronics and the biosensor and so many other things. But here, the farmer has also done the same thing in a very crude way, but it is a novelty. So it is a what? It is a innovation. It is not a simple process. It is what is a multi-stage process. Years of experience of that farmer has given this idea. So ideation must be there. When idea came in his mind, that ideation, it is converted into the, it has applied to what? This particular thing. He found this opportunity where this idea can be given, and he applied that opportunity, that idea to this agricultural field. So innovation, it is what? It is nothing but it is the production, adoption, assimilation, or exploitation of a value-added novelty in the economic and social spheres. So exactly the same thing happened. The renewal of enlargement of products, that may be this also the innovation. Renewal of the services may be there. Renewal of the markets may be there. Development of new methods for production. And as product may not be the new, but the development of a new method, it is what? It is the innovation. Establishment of new management system, that is also the innovation. Nowadays, you can see here, as the COVID situation came, many more people, they are sitting at their home and doing their work from home. Even also, we are giving this webinar from home. Otherwise, the practice of giving the lectures, practice of inviting the speakers at your colleges and other thing, it was going on. But now it is what? The situation had changed. We have adapted and we have gone to innovative step. That is what now we are going all for webinars instead of the physical lectures as such. So here the innovation, it is what? It is both a process or it is a product or the outcome. So you can give the innovation at anywhere. It may be the product may be known. You can give the process, a new process, or you may develop a new product which will give what? Which will give a benefit over the previous known product. So that is what? That is the innovation. Now here, the different people, they have defined what is innovation. Out of that, the one important thing given by Kettner, that innovation includes the original invention and the creative use. The creative use must be there, and defines the innovation as what? It is the generation, admission, realization of new ideas, products, and services. Now, what this definition says? There must be the generation of idea. There must be the generation of idea must come in your mind. A new idea must come in your mind. It must be admitted. It must be realized by you. And then you can give what? You can give or develop a product or a service. So the ideation, it is what? It is main thing in the innovation. You must have the idea. You must think in that way. So ideation is there. And then after that, when the idea comes in your mind, you have to apply it. For that, you must see a good type of opportunity. So innovation needs what? The ideation and the search of opportunity also. So both the things must be there in your mind. At one side, you have the idea, and then at which particular time or at which particular opportunity, you must apply that idea. So there are two dimensions of innovation. What is the degree of novelty? How much it is newer? That is, whether it is new for a firm, new for your college class, or it is new for a market, new for the industry, or new to the entire world. So when it is new to the entire world, then it is what? Then it gives a very great impact as such. And then the kind of innovation, whether it is a process or whether it is a product. So these are the two dimensions. That is what the degree of innovation, and then whether it is a product or it is a process, that is a type of innovation as such. So here, now, previously the innovation which we are talking, it was what? It was not in a very proper manner. It was just a multi-stage process. It was going on in a natural way, and then the person get ideation. But sometime we need what? We need the systematic innovation. Now, what is this systematic innovation? It is nothing but a purposeful and organized search for the changes, and this we want to be inculcated in the students, in the minds of students, and that's why we try to establish what the innovation centers, incubation centers, and so many other things. So it consists of what? The purposeful and organized search for the changes. So purposeful and organized search for the changes, then the systematic analysis of opportunities. So opportunities, you have to go for the analysis of opportunity. First of all, you must detect the opportunity, analyze it, and then what type of changes you can offer, that you have to see. That is nothing but what? That is nothing but the systematic innovation, and that is what? That is expected from the students of the science, students of technology, those who are studying or those who are taking the higher education. Not simply they are going by the syllabus, applying it to a certain type of the known thing, but no, you can go for a purposeful and organized search for the changes, and then search for the opportunity where you can apply that particular change in such a manner that it will affect the economy, it will affect the society, and so many other things. So now, what are the sources of innovation or the innovative opportunity? We say that idea is coming in our mind, but we must have the opportunity to apply that idea. So the two things are there in the innovation. Idea must come, and you have to search for an opportunity. Now, opportunity may come by various ways, and there are different ways of opportunity. Unexpected opportunity, incongruity, process need, industry, market structure, change in the demographics, perception, change of the perception, occurrence of the new knowledge also, it will give what? It will give the opportunity. Now here, you will see the unexpected, the product process, etc., for which there were no great expectations, and yet it did well. Now here, in the field of microbiology or in the field of biology, there are so many examples where the unexpected opportunities were there and the product was developed. The unexpected things, they have occurred and the product was developed. The great example, it is of the penicillin. The penicillin, when the First World War it was going on, at that time the soldiers, they were suffering from the wounds and the staphylococcus, and at that time what was the treatment to treat the wounds? It was what? It was the therapeutic agents like what? Like the your sulfonamides and other things. Now Staphylococcus aureus, all of you know, which causes the pus, it has gained the resistance to the sulfonamides, and then the scientists, they were searching for the alternative type of the ways, and out of that the people were thinking that some microorganism may be there which can kill the microorganism. That is the concept of antibiotic. It was started in the minds of people or in the minds of scientists, and in that all of you know how the Alexander Fleming got an unexpected type of what? Unexpected type of the discovery of the penicillin. But what happened in the First World War? The penicillin, it was discovered, but later on it couldn't come to the marketable form. In the marketable form it came in 1942 or like that, where the Fleury and Chen, they developed the actual purified product. So this was what? This was the unexpected type of the opportunity. Now there is an unexpected opportunity, it came in the last year. Now in the month of October or in the November last year, if someone has said that next year, that is after January, there will be a vast requirement of masks and the PPE kits. If someone has predicted this, people said that the person, he is a fool. Why there is a need of mask? Why there is a need of PPE kits? But after January, what happened? There was a tremendous demand for the PPE kits and then the mask. And then in India, where the PPE kits were very costly, we were importing it. And now what we are doing, we are manufacturing it. So many companies, they have come forward. So many people, they have come forward, gave the innovation. And then now there is what? There is an unexpected and unanticipated market for PPE kit that has opened. So this is what? This is the unexpected opportunity where the people have developed the new technology, new things, that how to prepare from different PPE kits from different material, how to prepare the mask from different material, and now that become a great business. Many more people, they are doing this business of mask and the PPE kit. So this is what? This is the unexpected type of opportunity. Now incongruity. Now incongruity, it is the when the demand grows steadily, but profitability does not, and some portion of a process seems to be awkward. Now what is this? Now I can give you here the example of what the biofertilizers. Now the biofertilizers are going to popular, they are becoming popular in a very steady manner, but and the profitability, it is not that much. And in that case, what happened? There are certain type of the certain type of what limitations or certain type of the difficulties in preparing the biofertilizer, in giving what, in giving the storage and stabilization of biofertilizer. So the process seems very awkward. And then the producers and suppliers, they what they do, they sell it according to their belief. So arrogant belief is there as such, and in that you have to give what? Now this become what? This gives the incongruent type of the opportunity. Now here I can give the example of one such person who did this, who grabbed this opportunity and developed a nice type of what? Nice type of a business. Now it is the Wise Organic, Gujarat-based startup. This Wise Organic aims to reduce the chemical consumption in the agriculture sector to ensure a greener future. Most of the farmers desist from adopting the organic farming, biofertilizer techniques, and so many other things. Because of what? Because of the initial costs involved, and there are certain other difficulties. Many farmers still, they rely upon the chemical fertilizer. So because of what? Because of the certain limitations and the certain problems, the cost involved in what? In the biofertilizer. Now Wise Organic, which was founded by Prakash Vaksia in 2017, what he did? He prepared one particular thing, that is the low-cost production of biofertilizer and biopesticide process, where he developed one particular type of a plant or one particular type of a machine called as the MyLab. For that, he is providing a certain type of inocula, and that MyLab, it is what? It is, it can be set up at the farmer, at the farm of the farmer, and he can, and the farmer can develop the biofertilizer. Even he can sell that particular biofertilizer to other, and it become what? It become cost effective. So here, now this is what? This is the Vaksia's plant, and this is what MyLab kit, which is available. Now Prakash Vaksia says, with the help of MyLab machine, a farmer can also start his own business in providing a low cost biofertilizer and sell them 80 rupees per liter. If a farmer buy biofertilizer from market, which are existing companies, it costs nearly about 300 rupees per liter and can be used only for 1 acre of land. But this MyLab kit and his machine produce what? Produce the same biofertilizer which cost only 50 rupees per liter, and it can be useful for more than 10 acres. So this is the innovation which he has done, and where he has done in the incongruent type of opportunity. So he converted that particular incongruency into what? In a better manner. So that is the entrepreneurship in the biology or in the biofertilizers. Now, another opportunity, it may be a process need. Now, it may be what? You may have to go for redesigning a process or replacing a link in process as such, which is a weak link. We have to apply a new knowledge, making it possible so that a missing link can be developed and you can have a new type of the method or new type of the process which is more economical and giving a more product. Now there are so many examples for this. Alcohol production, I can give the example of alcohol production. Most of the alcohol production in our country, it is going from the molasses, and we have a very big demand for the alcohol. Nearly about 700 to 800 crore liter it is requirement per year for the alcohol by our country, and we are only producing 355 crore liter as such, and rest of the gap which is there between 355 and 700 to 800 crore liter, this gap, it is totally imported from the other countries. Now why we cannot produce? Because we are using only molasses. But other countries, what they are doing, they are producing it from cellulosic waste. We are not going for that. So we have to develop that particular process, convert the cellulosic mass into what? Into the reducible sugar, and ferment that reducible sugar into what? Into the alcohol. So if you give a pre-treatment, a good pre-treatment to the cellulosic mass, which is cost effective, convert it into the reducible sugar and give the more product. So that is the one example where we can think, where young students or the young scientists, they can think over it. And there is a very good example of this. it was for insulin production by recombinant DNA technology, it is Humulin. Now when the insulin it was required, when it was seen that the animal source of insulin, it is giving different problems after some time, so people started thinking that why we should not produce the human insulin by use of rDNA technology. And all over the world the research was going on, and then there were two groups of the scientists. One was the Boyer's group and another is the Itakura group. So both of them, they have given the method almost in similar time, that is the production of insulin by rDNA technology from the genetically engineered E. coli. But the problem was what? The problem was when the Nobel Prize, it was declared, it went to Itakura, but not to the Boyer. Now, there was a very important missing link in the insulin production. What was that missing link? The recombinant protein, that is of the insulin, it was produced as a hybrid protein, and it must be separated from what? The penicillinase enzyme protein, so that we can get the pure of what? The pure of insulin, insulin protein. Now, when you go for cleavage of what? The penicillinase protein and the insulin protein, it's a tedious job, it's a tricky job. Even you have one amino acid also extra in what? Or it is missing from the insulin protein, then it can give the allergy. Now that process could not be given. Now at that time, what the Boyer did, he was not getting the Nobel Prize, but he developed what? He developed this purification process for insulin. And then with the help of that, he developed He purified the human insulin from recombinant protein. He could not get the Nobel Prize, but out of that, out of his knowledge, he developed one company, Eli Lilly Company, which is founded by him and which is the topmost company in what? Topmost company in the world who is making what? Your human insulin. And then he earned billions of dollars over that. So there are so many such examples where the process need type of the opportunity may be there. So here the Bayer has used this opportunity. Now the market, industry market structure, rapid growth of an industry, viability of traditional market, definition, market definition, segmentation, convergence of technologies, the way of business. Now there are, now when we go for recombinant DNA technology, it is not the one simple technology, but it is the convergence of different technologies which gives what? Which gives the product development. So in this case, you have so many type of opportunities for the innovation, because different technologies, they come together. Then way of business is done in a change, is changing rapidly. For example, nowadays the old type of the business that is going, that is from the shop business or the retail business, it is now changing to what? To the online business. Now this is what the way of market, it is changing. So if you opt this particular method, your business will run more rapidly than that of what? Than that of the old type of the retail business as such. So when this online business came, at that time people were not sure that whether this business will go on or not. But nowadays what we can see, again because of this COVID and other thing, the online business is more preferable. And this is again what it is, the type of opportunity that people are grabbing. So this is what, these are the different things. Then demographics, change in the demography, change in the population, the size of population changes, the educational status changes, and then the people demand for more and more type of the new product. Employment, as the employment grow, now always people now want the ready to eat food. Previously it was, the practice was not like that, this. Now again what we are having the ready to eat food and the food chains. Because of what? Because the employment, it is increasing. People don't have the time to give for give a time for what? For the cooking and all other thing. Then the income, it is also increasing. As income is increasing, the lifestyle is also changing. And then we need what? We need the innovation as such in our business. So that may be what that will. Then perception. When a change in the perception takes place, the fact doesn't change. For I can give you here a very simple example. In the olden previous days, all of you might be knowing that the curd is curd was sold at your doorstep. The milkmaids, they are coming with what? The curd, and we were taking. But now the perception has changed. People want cleanliness. People want hygienic product. People want sanitation. And because of that, what is there? Now the packeted curd is available. And people buy that particular thing. Nowadays, the curd selling or milk selling at your loose curd selling at your doorstep, it is not there. You go to a certain type of the big shop, and from there you get what? You get the curd, which is a packeted one. Now the curd is same. There is no change as such, but there is a meaning, or the perception have changed. People want the product in a better packed manner and in a very properly sanitized manner as such. So that is what, there is the perception, how it will give the opportunity. The new knowledge. Now the new knowledge, it is always, it become what? It becomes a superstar in the entrepreneurship and innovation. The knowledge, it is not necessarily be the scientific or technical. Among the history making innovation, knowledge based innovation rank high. Now why it is so? The characteristics of knowledge in based innovations are longest lead time of all innovation, that is for 25 to 30 years, almost always based on convergence of different kinds of knowledge and technology. So I can give again give the example of RDNA technology. Different kinds of knowledge are required, and then we are getting better and better type of the product. So it is the innovation is more. Then what are the specific requirement for knowledge-based innovation? Now here, when you take a knowledge-based innovation, you have to go for analysis of all necessary factors. When you go for genetically engineered microorganism, you have to think for what is its effect, what is its effect on the environment, what is its effect on the consumer, and so many other factors you have to consider. There must be a clear focus on the strategic position, and then ability to learn a practice entrepreneurial management. So you have to change your management also when you develop a product or when the knowledge-based innovation is going on. So that is the thing. Then there are unique risks in the knowledge-based innovation. What is that? Now the window of opportunity for establishing a position is very small. Now this is what, this is a current situation of COVID. What is that? As the COVID came, people start searching for what? For the early detection and correct detection of what? Of the COVID. Now there was a method. There was a method. That is what all of you know, RT-PCR, real-time PCR. In India, it was costly. Now one company from the Pune, they have come forward and developed the very first indigenously prepared RT-PCR kit. And the opportunity, the window of opportunity for that, it is very small, because people were dying of the COVID, and you have to develop that particular thing in a very short period. So window of opportunity, it is very small, and you are getting the benefit of your knowledge only for what? Until and until this COVID will continue. Now, once this window opportunity closes, when this COVID will go, at that time, all this kit business, then PPE kits manufacturing and other thing, they will what? They will shake out. Because this opportunity, when it closes, at that time, there will be what? There will be no need of all these things as such. There must be receptivity to the knowledge-based innovation. So people must accept this what? The knowledge-based innovation. They must rely upon you, and for that you have to develop a confidence. So your knowledge must be very perfect, and that is what? That is a knowledge-based innovation. So now, innovation dimensions. What are the innovation dimensions? They are the, what is the form of, what is the function, what is the extent, and what is the timing of innovation? That is what, that is very important. Now here, the form may be, it may be a technology-based form, it may be a product or the process service, it may be a market-based form, that is you are creating a new market, new buyers or the new clients, organization. You have to change the structure of your organization or the function in an innovative way so that you will get more business. So that is what, that is the form of the innovation. Then function. Now innovation must have, it must give the improved quality. It must reduce the cost of product. It should perform the new function. There must be newness. It must enhance the current market attractiveness. Increase the current market offerings. It enters market not currently served, means what? Untapped markets, there your innovative product must enter so that you will get a more type of the business. Improves the learning curve, enhances the economies of scale, permits the production of better quality offering, enhances the human growth and potential. So these functions are expected from your innovation. If your innovation, or what you call as the innovation, should be the innovation, then it must have all these type of the functions. Then and then only your innovation, it can give the opportunity, it can give the opportunity, and you can be the good type of entrepreneur. So what is the extent? Now, extent of innovation, in the earlier slides also I have given that extent, it may be what? It may be from one group or it may go up to the entire world. It may be a new thing for a small group. It may be a new thing for a given market. It may be a new thing for an industry, or it may be a new thing for whole world. Now here, if you see on the right hand side, it is 0 degree. Innovation is there in the center. If it is what? if it is not differing from the reference point, then there will be no innovation. But as it go on changing, it go up to 45 degree, it gives the evolution, variation, incremental change and continuous. Then if it goes to 135, it will give what? Revolution, reorientation, discrete changes as such. And it entirely changes to a 180, exactly opposite, then it will give what? It will give a new reference point and a new class of product. So that is what? That is the extent of innovation. Then timing. When you go for innovation, at that time, when you do the innovation, it must hit the market for the first time. Then you will be the successful innovator and entrepreneur. You may be a second, that may be a quick second and quick third, and then after that, all are the followers. So you must try to become first or second and not the latter followers. So there, you have to think continuously and innovate, update, and go for the opportunities. So that is what, that is the innovation as such. Now, how is the innovation process? It may be the product-oriented conversion process. Inputs are there, materials, knowledge is there. You go for R&D, design, conversion of material according to the design and R&D into what? Into the product. So that is what? That is the product-oriented conversion process. It may be technology market-oriented process. Inputs are there. What are the inputs? The customer needs. According to the customer need or satisfaction, you have to give what? The conversion, that is the technological concept. Apply scientific knowledge, design a product, manufacture it, get the product which satisfies the customer. So that is what? The technology market-oriented conversion. Here, there are three phases of innovation. The phase one, the very first thing is that the goal setting. You have to set the goal for what we are going to do the innovation. What is the purpose? What you are going to solve the problem? Then you identify the project, select the project. And for this, what you need the establishing of climate of innovation. That is very, very important. If there is no climate of innovation, we don't have the innovation and the progress. Now I can give you here the very good example of what, of the old America, that is as such in the 1860s or like that. At that time, mostly it was what? It was the South America. It was dependent on the agricultural business, particularly on what? Particularly on the cotton, and more is the cotton. Now, North America, it was totally on the industry side. So there was a competition between South America and North America. At that time, one person who was not having any background, any family background of what? Of the scientific studies, education or research, he developed himself. His name was George Washington Carver. You must have heard this name. He came from a slave family, but without giving any type of what, any type of the blame on the society or like that, he developed himself, opted, observed for the opportunities, gave development, innovation, and he came to South America and he gave the different type of innovation and he developed the entire America. Now, he has developed many more things in the agriculture and his name is famous, that is Dr. George Washington Carver. In the name of George Washington Carver, a very big type of the award, it is given to the industrialist who made a certain type of social and the economic impact. As such, last year it was given to one Indian person who is the owner of what? Owner of the Praj Technologies Pune for different type of innovations. Now you can see this climate of innovation, it was started in America in 1860 and like that. And then after that, the America developed. So credit goes to such type of the people. And establishment, now we are thinking about what innovation in our country. We are saying that our colleges must develop the innovative cells and other incubation cells and so many other things. Now there must be a constructing innovation investment portfolio. You have to support the the innovation investment, development, developing the organizational structure to support the innovation. That is what different type of the facilities must be given. Facility center must be there. Then defining the product and process goals. Now, in fact, then comes the phase two: research and development, production, and then the diffusion, that is entering in the market. At this time, we are just coming in the phase one. So, lot of things to be done in our country, and it is what it can be done by the young scientists, young people, students, and for innovation. It is not like that. What is your background? From which particular society you are coming? What is your status of education? Even a BSc student can also do the innovation, and he can be the entrepreneur. Only thing is that the establishing of the climate for innovation, it is very, very necessary, and that we have to do. So now after this, after talking for the innovation, now all of you might be knowing and must have understood what is innovation. Now we'll go for the bio-entrepreneurship. So what is the entrepreneurship? Now it is what? It has come from the French word, entrepreneurship. Now, which was introduced in the 16th century for what? For those, the military leaders actually, who led their military expeditions, who were in the search of opportunities and innovation and risk to gain victory. So they, at that time also, though it was not in the business, but whatever was the mission, what the expedition was there, it was nothing but what? Search of opportunity, that you must search for opportunity. Opportunity with innovation, you have to apply your innovation, and then very important thing is that you must have the ability to take the risk. Then and then only you can get the victory. So such a person, he was called as an entrepreneur. Later on, it was appeared in the Oxford English Dictionary in 1933. Then after that, the definition was given. An entrepreneur is an individual with advanced economy and introduces something new, like a method of production, simply which we had talked in the previous slides, that is the innovation, like a method of production which is not tested by the experience in the branch of manufacture concern, or a product with which the consumers are not familiar, or a new source of raw material, or of new market and the like. So entrepreneurship, that's why I said very first time, that is what the entrepreneurship or the bio-entrepreneurship and the innovation, they are what? They are the sides of the same coin. For entrepreneurship, you must have the innovation, and without innovation, you cannot enter in the entrepreneurship. So you better understand the innovation, and for innovation, what you need? You need, it is what? It is the ideation, that is what? Coming an idea to your mind, and then application of that idea to what? To the opportunity. Search for opportunity with what? With risk to gain the victory. So if you have that ability of taking the risk and applying your innovation to the opportunity, then you can be a good type of entrepreneur. Thus, entrepreneurship is a process of numerous activities in which entrepreneur is a person always creates something new and exploits such idea into the opportunities by accepting the risk and uncertainty with so entrepreneurship, it is not a very simple thing. It is not like that, that you are going for one particular type of what? Syllabus, one particular type of a training course, and then you are going to be the entrepreneur. Entrepreneurship doesn't require any degree or like that. It requires a degree, it requires a knowledge, but it is not necessary that you must be the engineer, you must be the PhD or whatever it may be. It is what? It is the, your mind must be creative, idea must come in your mind, and the entrepreneurship is what? It is a fusion of your of the capital, technology, and human talent. So this is what, this is the entrepreneurship. Now there are different types of entrepreneur are there. So we are not going into the details of all these types. They are aggressive, cognitive, imitative, Fabian, drone, rational. Then the entrepreneurship may be private or public. It may be a small or large and so many other things. Now, what are the skills which are required for entrepreneur? That is very important. There are a number of skills which are required for the entrepreneur. It is not a simple thing that you are getting one degree and you become the entrepreneur. Your degree may be the basic, and then the other things which are required, they are more than that. So entrepreneurial skills, they are what? They are of three types. They might be inherited, or you might have acquired during your everyday experience, or through your special training during your academics, or there are certain skills which are what? They might be inherited or acquired. Both possibilities are there for them, or by both ways they can be acquired. That's why we call it as a borderline type of the skill. So what are the total entrepreneurial skills? Desire to achieve independence, that is what, ability to work independently, risk bearing, locus of control, positivity in action, ability to find and explore opportunity. This is very important. You have to find the opportunity, you have to detect the opportunity, and you have to explore that opportunity. Flexibility, then perseverance, it is a very important thing. Interpersonal skills, efficacy, innovation, always you must have the innovation. How you can become, or how your product, it is new than the existing one. How your process is newer than others. So, and how it is economical. Then the time orientation, because the time of innovation, it is very much important. If you are in the previous slide, I said, if you are first to hit the market, then you are most successful one. If you are second, you are maybe similar one as that of the first. But after that, third, and then the laterals are the followers. Then power to influence, business communication skill, ability to utilize resources, technical skills, predict future, monitoring and evaluation, and so on. Now inherent skills are there. Desire to achieve, power to influence others, positivity in action, then acquired through your everyday life, the locus of control, flexibility, interpersonal skills, then efficacy, time orientations, ability to utilize resources, technical skills, then borderline. These skills may be acquired during lifetime, or some persons may inherit. Positivity in action, risk bearing, and the prediction of future. How you can predict the future, that what will happen in the future, that is there. Now, what are the skills which are acquired? Now we are talking about the microbiology. So there are certain skills of entrepreneurship which can be acquired through your training in context of microbiology. Now independence. Now how is this? This is due to the fact that the microbiology, when we perform our practicals, we have to perform so many things independently. Like media preparation, taking observation at particular time, for which student is solely responsible. He is trained to handle instruments independently and design experiments independently. So the ability to work independently that is very much required in the entrepreneurship. And if you perform your practical very sincerely, then you can develop this character of working independently. Ability to explore opportunity. There are various factors why microbiology or bioscience person acquire this skill. A vast microbial and biodiversity exists with different interactions with animal, plant, environment, and production of secondary metabolites. So opportunities are there. You have to think over this. With knowledge of these interactions, microbiologists, biologists can start thinking utilization and application of such interaction to mankind, which explore the opportunities. So it will give you the opportunities when you start thinking in that direction. Similarly, various problems which are related to environment, health, agriculture, come across during the biology. Now this is a good example. Now it is happening, that is of the COVID-19. Now when the COVID-19 came, everywhere in the world, there is a rat race for what? There is a rat race. The problem has come. Now people are searching for what? People are searching for vaccine. And only microbiologists can give what? The vaccine production. So this is what? This is the opportunity. This is what? How the problem which is coming, the health problem which is coming, it opens up the opportunity, and there you have to work. Now all companies, they are working for what? They want that they should be the first to produce the vaccine. Their vaccine should come in the market first. So that is what? That is the opportunity. Thus, where there is a problem, there is an opportunity to work and solve the problem as such. So there are so many opportunities which are existing in the field of microbiology as such. Then the perseverance, quality of sticking to a job till the success is achieved. Now this skill is more observed and it is required in case of microbiology student who studies the subject by involving in it and doing the tasks or practical sincerely. This is because for the success in the practical and to get the expected result, microbiology demands this quality and get developed due to nature of practical in the subject. So the perseverance, it is too much required in what? In the entrepreneurship. You should not give up that it is not happening means what? It is not of our use. No, you must go till the end, till the thing is achieved. And that quality is developed during what? During your practicals on microbiology and your projects, if you are doing it very sincerely. So you can develop this quality in yourself. Innovation, as I told you, large microbial and biodiversity is there, problem diversity is there, process diversity is there, product diversity is there. There is an induction of thinking, which leads to what? To develop and start a process of innovation in the mind of student. If you go in the life sciences, majority of the innovations, they are in the biotechnology and microbiology. All are related to microbiology and biotechnology as such. Innovations, they are coming. Technical skills, various technical skills are developed which are needed for different areas of business. Owner must know the technology and the skills regarding the business so that he is not dependent on the others for technology. Ability to utilize the resources. What resources are available? Raw materials, technology, manpower, optimum use of this can be acquired during your practical training. So time orientation, this management is an important factor. Time management is an important factor in the business, for the business success. To become successful microbiologist also, time management is must. You can learn how to utilize time when you perform your practicals. Now, what are the possible entrepreneurship available in the life science? If you go to the agriculture, there are so many areas like biofertilizer, biopesticide, organic farming, then soil analysis, agro-waste utilization, agricultural consultancy, all the areas where you can go for the microbiologists can go and do their business with their knowledge. So we will give you, I will give you the examples of for these biofertilizers, biopesticides, how you can develop. Then the plant-based, the floriculture, agroforestry, horticulture, bamboo culture, these are what, these are the other areas for the biology people. Now here, this is what, this is the floriculture, extraction of oil from marigold flower. Now this is a very big business and it is going on only from the marigold flower people used to extract. But one person, again, who is what, who is the who is a farmer, a school dropout farmer, what he thought, why I should not extract the oil from entire plant, not only from the flowers. And he developed that particular technology and he becomes a successful entrepreneur. So a dropout person, school dropout person, can develop such type of the thing and become a successful entrepreneur. So now animal resources. So the fish farming, poultry, prawn culture. Now fish farming, poultry, and all these, you can go for the canning of all these things. Then fish farming, a good type of the fish which is free from diseases. Now that is very important, that it that you need to develop. How will you go for aquaculture where the disease free atmosphere will be there? Now that you must know. Now I can give the very simple example. Now in the fish farming, particularly in the freshwater fish farming, now a pond is developed and in that the nitrogen source it is given, or a feed is given which contain the high nitrogen or high protein. Now what happen? Fish consume that and it increases what? It increases the ammonia in what? In the pond. And because of that ammonia, fish start dying. Now what you can do, what is the role of microbiologist here? You can introduce the culture. You can introduce the culture. The culture, it may be of chemolithotropic organism, which can oxidize the ammonia into what? Into the nitrogen. So the nitrogen oxidizing bacteria or nitrogen compound oxidizing bacteria, ammonia oxidizing bacteria, if you use, that will give what? That will, or it's a chemolithotrope. If you introduce that culture in what? In the pond, what it will do? As soon as the ammonia will develop in the pond, it will release that ammonia into what? Convert it into what? Oxidize into the molecular nitrogen and release it to the atmosphere. So it will reduce what? It will reduce the ammonia. And that is the problem which is going in the fish farming, where you can enter as a microbiologist. In the poultry also, you can develop a feed for poultry, a probiotic feed or like that. So the poultry can be developed in a healthy way, prawn culture and so many other things. Then food processing, now this food processing and production, it is the hot cake nowadays. It's a demanded type of the business where the microbiologists have much more scope. New method of preservation and packing, you can go for new type of probiotic food, functional foods, development of food products. Then nowadays the FSSAI, that is what, Food Safety and Standards Act of India, which has been introduced, which needs what? The food safety audits. You can enter in the food safety audit field, go for consultancy. So there are what? There are various type of the innovative idea. You can enter in the food production and the other type of the business related to the field, related to the food. Diagnostics, all of you know, there are various problems. Rapid diagnostic kits are required. You can develop those kits. You can think over it. RT-PCR, which has been developed, rapid kits you can develop. Detection of TB, rapid detection of TB. It is a burning issue in the India. Then detection of what? Detection of various type of the agents. For example, in the frozen food, L-monocotogens, which gives what? Which gives the so many problem in the pregnant woman if it is consumed in the dairy product. So detection of L-monocotogens, it is what? It is again the new type of the field and development of the kits it is required. So many type of the areas are there in this diagnostics. Then pharmaceuticals, in the sky is the limit. Production, biomedical instruments, and then the pharmacovigilance, it is what is the new area where you can apply your knowledge. Then biochemical solvents, industrial products. As I told you, the production of alcohol, which is much more needed, and from different type of the new sources, different acids, gluconic acid. The gluconic acid is much demanded nowadays. Where it is used, we know the gluconic acid is used in the pharmaceutical industry and dyeing industry and so many other things. But for gluconic acid, it is used in what? In the construction industry for making what? The proper type of the concrete, proper setting of the concrete in the building business. So large amount of gluconic acid is required. Again, that we are importing it from what? From the other countries, we cannot develop. Then increasing the efficiency of old processes, production of different enzymes. Enzymes you can have. Why this RDNA technology is costlier in our country? Because the tools of RDNA technology, that is nothing but the enzymes which are not produced indigenously in our country. So you can go, you can look for those enzymes, produce the enzymes at a lower cost, and make our dependent, make our country dependent on our own. That is what we call, that is our honorable Prime Minister says, Atmanirbhar. So we are not Atmanirbhar in the restriction endonucleases and all other type of the tools which are need for, which is a need for RDNA technology, and because of that we are not developing much more products. So then environmental sector, purification system, then development of specific inocula, that is the bioremediation, microbial remediation for what? For the industrial waste, that is the need. Then the sewage treatment plants, analytical lab, water water and soil analytical labs, water purification systems you can develop, new type of the systems you can develop and go for that. The development of specific inocula for the industrial waste is the best business as such. Then the dairy products, new type of the dairy products, development of new products, packaged milk products. Now there are so many products which are available currently in India. You have to develop them in a marketable form. Then traditional knowledge based products. Now locally known cuisines and the food products. Now we are not popularizing them. We are not popularizing them because they are not in a marketable form and a preservable form. So as our Prime Minister said again, vocal for local. So what is the local food? You find it out around you and try to make it acceptable worldwide. Market it. The yogurt which is prepared, or which is the product from outside, we are buying that, but we cannot market our Srikhand outside. So you have to go for such type of the things. Then the traditional cosmetics, I will show you the certain traditional cosmetic and certain type of the thing. Then the traditional medicines, traditional cleansing and herbal products, prepare them in a marketable form. So that is what, that is the innovation. So RDNA, modern technologies, RDNA technology, development of biosensors, nanobio products, they can give you so many type of opportunities as such. Now, this is what a traditional knowledge, a case study for a traditional knowledge, best product with innovation. Now, this is the microbial henna. Now, all of you know henna is used for what? For the hair dyeing and so many other things. Now, this is what we have developed, a process. It is actually going for the patenting. Now, we have developed three different shades, black, dark brown, red, orange. Traditional henna gives one color. Better conditioning of hair, shine to the hair, no chemicals, keeping time 15 days, and we have developed the process economics also. 100 gram packet, cost rupees 15 per packet. Daily packets, we can produce 400 packets of 100 gram. That is, it requires 6,000, and monthly, it is what? It is 1,80,000. Approximate profit, it is of what? It is of 30,000 per month. So here, what is the process economics? Space required is 400 square feet space, fixed cost, instrument plus rent plus electricity, daily routine cost, raw material collection plus packaging and miscellaneous, starting with minimum of 5 labors per day, collecting 8 kilograms of raw material labor per labor, and each labor will charge 300 rupees per day. Packaging cost is 50 paise per 100 gram, electricity charge and distribution charges total being, this is what, 4,500 per day cost. Approximately it goes 1,35,000 per month. 400 packets of 100 gram can be produced per day. Approximate estimate, it is of 1,50,000. That is that is of the production and distribution. It requires what? It requires 1,35,000 as I have given, 10,000 rent, other miscellaneous it is 5,000. So that will give you what? That will give the profit of nearly about 30,000 to 40,000 per month. So this is what? This is the technology which we have developed, and it is going for the patenting. AgroWest, we have developed the gluconic acid by solid state fermentation, and then we have developed what? We have developed the entire, again, the process economics for this. We have developed it from rice bran and the soybean meal. So this is what the costing of sodium gluconate by solid state fermentation we have prepared. It is nearly about 22 rupees, 22.50 paisa. So from 1 kg of mass, we can yield 6 to 7 grams, and the cost, it comes to nearly about 2.5 to 3 rupees per gram. So costing was done in 2006 on lab scale. So you can develop such type of the things, innovative things as such, according to the raw materials which are available in your local area. This is what, this is the biofertilizer production, azolla production, which I did in my college. And this azolla, it is distributed in what? Distributed in the different 50 villages to the farmers for developing such type of the ponds. And now what they are doing, they are generating their own azolla biofertilizer. So this is what, this is the biofertilizer. Then biopesticide, we had developed the biopesticide at our college, which is the HANPV type of the biopesticide. We are using HANP virus. So it is used for the protection for what? Protection against the one particular pest coming on what? Coming on the chickpea. So we have developed this method. Now, what are the factors to be considered for entrepreneurial success? There must be the innovation, financial resource management must be there, human resources, skilled and unskilled, both are required, marketing, it is important factor, and legal aspects. So all these things, they are required in any type of what, any entrepreneurial success as such. Now here, for the search of motivation for the entrepreneurship among the youths, now identifying the topics, areas in the syllabus which are new, upgradation of syllabus, motivational talks, lectures of the subject related entrepreneurs, visit to such establishment where students can interact directly with entrepreneur, competitions for student to write such entrepreneurial projects, competition like hackathon where a prototype of project can be demonstrated, giving some projects earn while you learn by employing the projects, training programs on the entrepreneurship, introducing intellectual property right concept, developing innovation and incubation center in the college. So you can make the climate of innovation in your institute. Now, what are the financial resource management? You have to, the very first step, it is what? Go for market survey. Now there are different agencies which are providing the finance. Nowadays, it is the MSME, medium and small scale industry, that is what they are giving the finances. You have to submit a project, and the formats of the projects, they are available on this website. Entrepreneur must submit a proposal with proper budgeting in relevant format. So you can get the support from government definitely, because government is now proactive in this case, and they are giving open up as such with the startups and in the entrepreneurial business. Type of business, example, whether it is agri-tech, biotech, chemical, electronics, food, etc. For every sector, respective ministries have funding schemes. For example, agri-tech business, following is the thing. Now, this is what, this is the agri-entrepreneurship, called as agri-clinics and agri-business center, AC and ABC scheme, a flagship program of Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. So what are the salient features? Age criteria 18 to 60 years, anyone can apply. Aspirants of agriculture and allied science graduates, environmental science, botany, zoology, chemistry, graduates, diploma holders, etc. can apply. Credit support, it is what you are getting, 20 lakh, 25 lakh, up to 1 crore with NABARD subsidy of 36%, general for general, and 44% for women, SC, ST, Northeast states. Credit from Mudra scheme is also available. What is the curriculum? Practical sessions on agriculture and allied sector, entrepreneurial marketing, accounting, finance, field and industrial visits, hands-on experience, detailed project report writing, DPR, exposure visits to innovations at national agricultural technology industries, information and computation technology, communication technology, ICT, and personality development. And then the post-training benefits, hand-holding support for venture establishment and incentives, theme-based refresher training programs, membership with Manage, SEBC, and Incubation Center. So you can apply, you can go for what? Now there are 139 nodal training centers all over the India. You can go on this website, www.acaabcmis.gov.in by choosing preferred type of the NTI center, or you can go for the email address which is given here, or go on the website www.agriclinics.net. on that you can get all type of the details of this particular scheme. Now if your product is innovative and you want to incubate the process, then government provide funds. For that, you can visit www.signiitb.org. Now, this is the sign. It is the Society of Innovation and Entrepreneurship at Indian Institute of Technology, Mumbai. That is IIT Bombay. So there, this sign, it is giving all type of the details, and they are supporting, they are giving the, providing you the information and giving the guidance for what, how you can get the funds for what, for your innovative idea and incubate your process into the business. So it is a very big type of the scheme, and you can take the advantage, those who are innovative and want to become entrepreneur. So what are the funding schemes under this? These are what? These are the Nidhi Prayas. It is the Indian rupees 10 lakh grant for prototyping. Then entrepreneur in residence. Here you will get the 3.6 lakh annual stipend for supporting entrepreneurs. Then Indo-Swiss cross-border program for early stage technologies. Then BioNest incubation support for life science startups at IIT Mumbai. So this is the financial support, equity-free prototyping, entrepreneurship stipend, seed grants, plug and play office, access to technical resources, boost up camps, mentoring and coaching, it is also available. Then business network, clinical trials, regulatory expertise, industry connect, investor meets and facilitation, media and visibility. Now these are the various schemes where you need ideation, then proof of concept, validation of your idea, then scale up and commercialization. So these are what Bio Ignition Grant, Biotechnology Ignition Grant, BIG, then BIRAC, and there are so many other grants they are available. So you can go on what, you can go on this type of the websites as mentioned here and get all type of the details, contact with Sign IIT Mumbai, Sign IIT B and get the details. So the summary, opportunity, search for opportunity, validate it, give proof of concept, test it, prototype funding, team, form a team, scale up your funding, early revenues, and then venture capital. So you can become an entrepreneur in what? In the biological field, microbiology, biotechnology. So at the end, I end up with what? With the saying of Dr. George Washington Carver, start where you are with what you have. Make something out of it. Never be satisfied. This is very, very important. So it is the it is the statement of great scientist and innovator, Dr. George Washington Carver. So thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Sanjeev Patankar, for your very elaborate, lucid, and very inspiring talk that you've given us, which was very elaborate and it highlighted all the main points of bioinnovation and bioentrepreneurship, beginning with opportunity, the skills required, how we need to go about it, what funds are available. I'm sure everyone has benefited today.
So any question, madam?
Yes, the floor is available for questioning. Any of the participants would like to place their question to Dr. Patankar?
I think there's one question in the chat box by Dr. Palvinder Kaur. He yeah. says, kindly tell which courses are required to enter food consultancy. Specific, any specific certification?
Yeah, actually, if you want to go for food safety, food safety audit, particularly most important is what nowadays it is the food safety audit. Food safety audit auditor's course. Now, for that, there are certain courses which are run by institute like say Symbiosis and other thing, the food safety courses. Then one course it was run at Lakshminarayan Institute of Technology, Nagpur, a certificate course in food safety. So you need to be approved type of the auditor, food safety auditor. Then you can go in this consultancy business regarding the food safety.
Thank you, sir. We have Subhadeep Shastri asking for the feedback link.
Feedback link?
I think our department will provide that.
Yes, the feedback link will be sent by email. So kindly check your mails.
Do we have any other questions, students? Any of the participants?
I think if there are any questions, they can post it to us, they can email us, and we will get your questions across to Dr. Patankar.
I can share the email ID also.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Sanjeev Patankar, for your presentation and your talk.
Yeah, thank you, madam.
Thank you, sir. I would now kindly invite Dr. Teja Savoykar to give the vote of thanks. Teja.
Thank you, Larissa. Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of Department of Microbiology, I, Dr. Teja Savoykar, take this opportunity to propose the vote of thanks. First and foremost, I thank the management, the principal of our college, Professor Vijay Pisulekar, sir, and Vice Principal, Sri GPP Kanulkar, sir, for always supporting and encouraging us to organize various talks and events. I express my sincere gratitude to our resource person for today, Dr. Sanjeev Patankar, sir, for graciously accepting our invitation and enlightening our participants on bioinnovations and bioentrepreneurship. We are also grateful to Dr. A.M. Deshmukh, sir, who consented to be guest for today's webinar despite his busy schedule. A heartfelt thanks to all the faculties and students of various colleges from all over the India for participating in large numbers and making this webinar a grand success. On behalf of convener, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to HOD Dr. Carolina Fernandez for her support and encouragement. I would like to place on record the immense hard work put in by the coordinators of Microtech Cell, Ms. Lochan Narvekar and Ms. Reema Desai for today's webinar. A big thank you to Ms. Larissa Menezes for excellent anchoring and as well as to Mr. Anchit Sheth Parker. With these kind words, we end today's session. Feedback forms will be mailed to you. Kindly fill the same to get your e-certificate. Thank you, one and all. Have a great evening.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Dr. Teja Savoykar. Thank you to the chief guests and the resource persons. Thank you to all the participants.
Thank you.
Sir, there is one question. Maybe you can reply to the person later. They wanted to know something about Azolla biofertilizer. Sir, if you are online, Mr. Pandurang Bhagat.
Yes, Miss, I'm online.
So even though the workshop I'm on the webinar is over, if maybe Sanjeev sir can answer in a few words.
Yeah, definitely. Please ask.
Sir, my question was, can you tell something more about the Azolla bio fertilizer you had prepared?
Yeah, actually we had developed this, actually the construction of the pond, we had developed with a very cheap type of the method, and it is workable in farm. A farmer can develop this type of the pond, and then you can grow this Azolla with very simple type of pond, simple type of the what you say, the conditions. So those conditions that I have as such, if you want, I will communicate with you and you can develop it.
Yes, sir, sure, sir. I would like to.
Simple thing.
Sir, can I call you after the meet, if you don't mind?
Definitely.
Thanks a lot, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir. Participants, you are free to leave. I wish you a good evening.
Okay.
And stay safe. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.